Hey everyone, I hope you're all in the holiday spirits because guess what? It's Christmas time! Yes, it is finally the holiday season, and if it feels like we've been waiting all year for this to happen, it's because we have. Everyone is out and about shopping for Christmas trees and presents, and that means more time spent in stores, and more time spent in stores can only mean one thing. Hearing Christmas music. Not Little Drummer Boy though, not yet. I am still going strong on that challenge. Love them or hate them, Christmas songs have become a staple of the holiday season. Stores play them, radio plays them, TV tries to replicate them for comedic effect.
Ding, fries it done, ding, fries it done, ding, fries it done, ding, fries it done.
It's not funny. But ladies and gentlemen, have you ever sat down and really listened to the lyrics of some of these tunes? Because they can be truly, truly frightening. For a holiday that's supposed to be all about love and spreading joy, these songs have a kind of hidden malice behind them. So today, I'm taking some time out of my week to highlight the top 6 most terrifying Christmas songs. Why top 6? Well, 6 is half of 12, and something about the 12 days of Christmas. I don't know, just follow me here. Start things off with something relatively easy that most people find creepy nowadays. Baby, it's cold outside.
I really can't
but
stay.
But baby, it's cold outside.
I've got to go
but
away.
But baby, it's cold outside.
This evening has
been hoping that you drop in.
So very nice.
I'll hold you.
Seems innocent enough, right? I mean, it sounds like a man is just concerned for the safety of his lady friend. After all, it does get pretty cold in the winter, and when temperatures are that frigid, slipping on ice does become more of an issue. So what's the problem? Well, you've all heard this lyric, right?
Say, what's in this
no cab.
Ooh, that is no good. So after having that accusation leveled at him, how does Dean Martin respond?
Say, what's in this
no
dream?
Cabs to be had out there.
He doubles down. Ladies and gentlemen, Dean Martin has doubled down. This is not a drill. I repeat, this is not a drill. We have a possible Me Too moment on our hands. Be ready to mobilize. Furthermore, I just now realized that the female part of this song isn't just sung by one voice, but is actually comprised of a chorus of women. Am I to take this to assume that this means that Dean Martin has done this to multiple partners whose lips looked equally delicious? Probably not, but isn't it fun to theorize? Up next is I Saw Mommy Kissing Santa Claus.
I saw Mommy kissing
Santa Claus
underneath the mistletoe last night.
Now this song isn't really creepy at first and requires more than a surface level look to find the true horror, but follow me here. So young Michael Jackson tells the tale of how he once saw his mother kissing Santa Claus when he was supposed to be asleep. Now one could easily assume that Santa Claus was just his dad in costume, but I'd like to offer a few points to counter that argument. Number one, the lyrics mention that mom thought Michael was asleep. Why would she be worried about being seen kissing her husband even if Michael was awake? Number two, I think Michael Jackson would be able to recognize his father even if he were dressed as Santa. I mean, what did Joe Jackson look like? And what did Santa Claus look like? The similarity is striking. Number three, why would the father dress up as Santa Claus in the first place? I mean, if all the kids were asleep, there'd be nobody to witness that but the mother. Does Michael Jackson's mom have some sort of kink for overweight men of a dubious nature that breaks and enters to people's houses through chimneys? Taking all these points into consideration, it seems to me that Mommy was indeed kissing somebody, and that somebody was not the father.
You are not
the terror then ramps up a bit when Michael Jackson proudly proclaims that he's going to tell his father what he saw.
I really did see Mommy kissing Santa Claus, and I'm gonna tell my dad.
Michael, no! Don't! You'll make an already bad situation worse! And this is supposed to be a peaceful holiday filled with joy and love and family values! Don't do it, Michael! Make love, not war! What do we have up next? Initially, I was debating on whether or not to put this on the list in the first place, but what is a list if not a stocking that you can just stuff more things into? And here we are. Version of the classic song Christmas Time Is Here is sung by the band Jars of Clay, and I initially heard it on the radio at my workplace. I was initially creeped out by the stripped down instrumentation, but then the singer's voice came in, and this guy needs a lozenge or something because his rasp is harsh. As the song continues, it becomes a lot less creepy, but I thought the opening minute or two alone were enough to put it on this list. Up next we have... absolute Christmas classic, this one cannot be forgotten. It's infectious, endearing, and of course, creepy as all hell, it's Up on the Housetop.
Up on the housetop, reindeer paws, out jumps good old Santa Claus, down through the chimney with lots...
I can almost hear you guys saying now, Erik, how can this song possibly be considered creepy? It's so cheesy, cheery, and adorable. How can you possibly call that creepy? Also, that's a very cool beard you have, very rugged. And to that I say, thank you. But as to the song, have you actually listened to what Santa is bringing these children?
First comes the stocking of little Nell. Oh dear Santa, fill it well. Give her a dolly that laughs and cries, one that can open and shut its eyes.
Santa? I'm pretty sure we have an entire subgenre of horror movies about dolls that show us that more realistic does not mean better. What else is he bringing?
Look in the stocking of little Bill. Oh, just see what a glorious fill. Here is a hammer and lots of tacks, a whistle and a ball and a whip that cracks.
Okay, so there's a lot to unpack here. Let's just start from the beginning. A hammer and lots of tacks. Okay, so even at this young age, Will is obviously a working man. Boy. Whatever. A whistle and a ball. Not sure what those things have to do with anything, but then a whip that cracks? Santa? What the heck would a child need with a whip? Seems like Santa is grooming this child to either be a slave driver or an absolute freak in bed, neither of which are particularly okay. Coming in at number two, we have... Now, this song is probably one of the oldest songs on the list. It's withstood the test of time, and for good reason. It's catchy, well-written, and has received so many covers that it was hard to narrow down a definitive version of this song, so I just picked one by a more recent pop star. Number two is Santa Claus Is Coming to Town.
Oh, oh, oh. You better watch out, you better not.
It's rare that I can just let the lyrics of the song speak for me, but these words are so acutely terrifying in context that I don't need to do much more than read them.
You'd better watch out. You'd better not cry. You'd better not pout. I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town. He sees you when you're sleeping. He knows when you're awake. He knows if you've been bad or good, so be good, for goodness sake!
Clearly, Santa Claus is a vicious warlord who regularly visits the towns under his control and puts any rebels to a gruesome and public death. So, it all comes down to this. What could possibly be more horrifying than a murderous Santa Claus? Well, you're about to find out. Love this song or hate this song, it is undeniably a staple on radio this time of year. It is also undeniably one of the most terrifying Christmas songs, if not one of the most terrifying songs of all time. The number one most terrifying Christmas song of all time is... I Want a Hippopotamus for Christmas.
I want a hippopotamus for Christmas. Only a hippopotamus will do. Don't want a doll, no dinky tinker toy. I want a hippopotamus to play with and enjoy.
Ladies and gentlemen, in case you are not aware of what kind of animal this girl is asking for, allow me to enlighten you with a few facts about the hippo. They can grow up to 5 feet tall and weigh a few tons. They've been clocked at running 30 miles per hour on land, and oh yeah, they're vicious, aggressive, murdering machines. Hippos, with their incisors able to grow up to 20 inches long, are one of nature's most aggressive animals and kill over 300 humans per year. That's over 75 times the amount of sharks that kill people per year. Their jaws have a bite force of nearly 2,000 pounds per square inch, and they have been known to attack humans without provocation, and this little girl wants one as a pet, she is dead! Unless... what if this girl is some kind of hippo queen? What if she can somehow communicate with them, and befriend them, and use them to kill people she doesn't like? What if she knows how deadly these things can be and is planning to gather an army of them to take over the human race? Oh, God, please spare us a most unpleasant demise and kill us now! Ah! Thank you all for joining me on this little journey through the 6 most terrifying Christmas songs I could think of. If you liked the video, drop it a like and subscribe. If you think I missed some, post them in the comments below. And keep in mind that even if I found these songs frightening, that doesn't mean that you can't enjoy them. After all, this holiday is one of acceptance for all people. So, whatever holiday you're celebrating, have a happy one.